हाई स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। नाउ कमिंग टू दिस टॉपिक ऑफ CRO प्रोब्स। सो ऑलरेडी वी नो अबाउट CRO, दैट इज कैथोड रे ऑसिलोस्कोप। नाउ वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट CRO प्रोब्स, दैट इज प्रोब्स फॉर CRO। द CRO प्रोब्स बाय विच वी कैन कनेक्ट एनी टेस्ट सर्क्यूट टू एन ऑसिलोस्कोप। द CRO प्रोब बाय विच वी कैन कनेक्ट any test circuit to an oscilloscope, but the probe should not create any loading issues or it should not disturb the circuit. It should not create any loading issues and it should not disturb the test circuit, so that we can analyze the test circuit with the signals properly on CRO screen. Next, these CRO probes has high impedance and high bandwidth. These CRO probes have high impedance as well as high bandwidth. Now coming to the CRO probe block diagram. So this one is your CRO block diagram. Okay, it is having totally three blocks that are of probe head,
coaxial cable as well as termination circuit. So here we are having the probe tip that is used to signal sensing element, so by which we can sense the signals. Here it is the probe head, another one is coaxial cable, here termination circuit. So this will be connected to the CRO. So this one is your block diagram of CRO probe.
Next, we are having different types of CRO probes. Now we discuss about those types of CRO probes.
So the first one is direct probes, second one isolation probe, third one is passive probes, and another one is active probes. First one direct probes, second one isolation probe, third one is passive probe, another one is active probe. So now we discuss about these probes in detail.
So this one is your direct probe.
Okay, this one is used in your labs. Okay, already have seen this CRO probe, that is direct probe. It is also called as 1:1 probe. It is also called as 1:1 probe. So it has crocodile pin, another one is shielded cable, that is the cable for CRO probe, and another one is connector at termination. So this will be connected to the CRO. Here the crocodile pin by which we can sense the signals, that is connected to the test circuit. Here this end is connected to the CRO. So in this direct probe, the stray capacitance of probes adds with the capacitance of oscilloscope. The stray capacitance of this probe adds with the capacitance of oscilloscope, hence by which at higher frequencies the total input impedance will become very low. Due to this stray capacitance, at higher frequencies the input impedance will become very low.
So it means that the direct probes are limited to low frequencies only. So these probes are limited to low frequencies only. Okay, so that one is your direct probe. Those are called as the 1:1 probes, and it does not provide any improvement in the input impedance, and hence it is called as the 1:1 probe. So the disadvantage in this probe is stray capacitance. That capacitance will be reduced by another probe,
that is isolation probe. So this one is the figure for isolation probe. So in this we are adding the carbon resistance in series with the shielded cable. We are adding the carbon resistance in series with the shielded cable to reduce the stray capacitance. So this probe is called as the isolation probe, and this probe is used to avoid the loading effect of the probe. This probe is used to avoid the loading effect of the probe. So this one is your isolation probe. So here we are connected the carbon resistance to reduce the stray capacitance, but due to this connection of the carbon resistance, there is a slight reduction in the amplitude of the signal. Okay, the slight change in the input also. So to avoid this, we need to use high impedance probes. Those probes are passive probes, that is the high impedance probe. Passive probe or high impedance probe. It is also called as 10:1 probe. So this one is the circuit for high impedance probe, that is the passive probe. So this entire circuit is for the passive probe. So this one is also called as 10:1 probe or high impedance probe or low capacitance probe. 10:1 high impedance and then low capacitance probe. It is also called as passive probe. Why? Because this circuit is having the passive components, that are the resistance and capacitance. Hence it is called as the passive probe. In this circuit we are having the resistors and then variable capacitor. This capacitor is also called as compensation capacitor, and it is the cable equivalent capacitance. So this one is of the R in and then C in. These are connected to the at the CRO input. Modified in the form of a bridge circuit. So this one is your equivalent bridge circuit of the 10:1 probe, that is passive probe. So it is having the resistances and then capacitance parallelly. So this one is your balanced bridge of the equivalent circuit of high impedance probe. So here we are having the parallel capacitances and resistances. So this bridge can be balanced by using this variable capacitor, that is C1. So at the balance condition, we can write the opposite resistance, product of opposite resistance will be equal, that is R1 into XC2 plus CN, that is equal to Rin into XC1. So where X is called as the reactance here. So here we can write it as R1 by omega into C2 plus CN, that is equal to Rin by omega, W into C1. So these W's will be cancelled out. So by which you can write it as R1 into C1, that is equal to Rin into C2 plus CN. Make it as the equation number 1. Now coming to the attenuation factor of high impedance probe. So the attenuation factor is defined as the ratio of input voltage to output voltage, that is Vi by V0. So from this we can write it as the attenuation factor. Alpha is equal to R1 plus Rin by Rin, that is equal to 10. So this value is 10, hence it is called as the 10:1 probe. By applying the resistance values, we can get the value 10. It is called as the 10:1 probe. So by which we can say that the input impedance increases by a factor of 10, while the input capacitance is decreased by a factor of 10. Now from the attenuation factor equation, we can write it as alpha is equal to 1 plus R1 by Rin, that is we can write it as alpha minus 1, that is equal to R1 by Rin. So by which we can write the equation for R1 equal to alpha minus 1 into Rin, that is the equation number 2. So from this equation 2 we can say that for the integer values of alpha, so R1 is greater than or equal to the value of Rin. For integer values of alpha, that is alpha is greater than 1. Now substituting the equation number 2 in 1, we get alpha minus 1 into Rin into C1 equal to Rin into C2 plus Cin. So by which we can write the equation for C1, that is equal to C2 plus Cin by alpha minus 1. Here the Rin resistance will be cancelled out. So this one is the equation number 3. So from this equation number 3, we can conclude that the value of C1 is less than the or equal to the value of C2 plus Cn for integer values of alpha, that is alpha is greater than 1. So this one is about your 10:1 probe, that is passive probe. It is also called as high impedance probe and low capacitance probe. Next, coming to this active probe. So it is having the blocks, fed source follower and BJT emitter follower, and then shielded cable. Here is the Rin and CN resistances. These are connected to the CRO, and it is having the probe tip for sensing the signals. Here the fed source follower that provides a high input impedance and low output impedance. It provides a high input impedance and low output impedance. Next, the BJT emitter follower, it eliminates the impedance mismatching. It avoids the impedance mismatching. And the other two parts, that are the shielded cable and this termination circuit, are same as in active probe. Okay, so this one is your active probe. So these are regarding your CRO probes. Okay, different types of CRO probes. Okay, thank you.